You give life, you are love, you bring light.
This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. Our Father and our God, we thank you for today, which is a day you have made. We rejoice and we are glad because this is a day of resurrection. This is our first among all days. Accept our thanksgiving. Lord, it's a day of rest. We ask that you give us rest in every ramification of our lives. Give us rest. Whatever is causing unrest for us, Father, lay them to rest this week. In the name of the Lord Jesus, your word says there remaineth a rest for God's people. Father, give us the rest of faith, the rest of belief and strong faith in you. Help us today to worship you in spirit and in truth. Accept our worship today, whether physical or virtual. Father, accept our worship today. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray for every member of our church. We ask that you visit each and every one of us today. Lord, answer the questions of our heart. Send your word to us. Where we hurt, Father, we pray that you will give us your balm, the balm of Gilead, to soothe our pain. In the name of Jesus Christ. Where we are confused, shed your light on our path and show us the way to go. In the name of Jesus. Today we pray for our pastors. You have said in your word that you will give us pastors that will feed us with your word. And so we pray today that you will anoint our pastors sufficient enough to feed us with the word of life today. Help us to know that they are human like us and to give them understanding instead of misinterpretation. Help us to love them instead of hating them. Help us to always pray for them instead of castigating them. Deliver us from the syndrome of the fourth word on the cross. When your son Jesus said, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, and people were saying that he was calling Elijah. Lord, deliver us from misunderstanding our pastors. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray for our leaders, our political leaders, military leaders, economic leaders, educational leaders, media leaders, and even leaders in our families. Lord, we pray that you will deliver them from the lies of the enemy. We know that they are almost always target of the devil because they control the destiny of humanity. And so, Heavenly Father, we pray that you will lead them. We pray that you will direct them to your will. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, the way the devil used David to torment the children of Israel in 1 Chronicles 21 verse 1 and also in 2 Samuel 24 verse 1, you will not allow our leaders to do such errors that will torment us in our nation, in our state, and in our neighborhood. Heavenly Father, we also pray for families today. You are the creator and establisher of families. We pray that you deliver our families from troubles. Every family that is in trouble, Lord, make a way for them where there seems to be no way. I pray today that you will give every woman the spirit of humility and submission. No woman amongst us will pack her load out of her place today. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray for the men. Grant us to love our wives the way you love your church, that no man will beat his wife today. No man will maltreat his family today. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we pray for the children. Grant them grace to respect and to honor their parents, so that their days can be long here on earth, so that you can bless them. In the name of the Lord Jesus, Lord, our offerings today you will not reject. You will accept and bless us in return. In the name of the Lord Jesus, Lord, I pray that upon the altar today there shall be fire. Angels shall ascend and descend. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Lord, this Sunday will not be the last for any one of us. We shall live to celebrate many more Sundays in the land of the living. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.